Sairam, everybody. Welcome to all of you to SaiWisdom.com. Thanks to Swami for making this possible. I hope and sincerely trust that you would follow the whole talk and come forward with your own suggestions and comments. Thank you very much for your time. Well, my friends, we are at a time right now totally confused. We have with us a new generation that has not been exposed to Swami at all. They didn't see Swami. Most of them have not gone through his literature either. And the senior people, many of them who had intimate contact with Swami, either they have left or far away from us. So the new generation with us today is confused. And we have another category of devotees who are in dilemma as to what to do as what not to do. To be or not to be, that is the question with this group. And third category of devotees are those who are simply silent for themselves. Let things go. Let things go. Let the sleeping dogs lie. We are not worried. So this I call indifferent group. There is a section of devotees here who are staying because of their children who are studying in educational institutions. And by and large, students, staff and hospital staff, paramedical staff, that is the composition of devotees in Prashanthi Nilayam. We cannot rely on education institutions because students come and go. Soon after they complete their studies, they go. We need to motivate the teachers so that they'll be charged with Sai devotion and Sai message, so that they would disseminate to students left to them, so that they would also inspire them to be true messengers of Sai in future. As it is, I don't find any such motivational talks or motivating force making faculty members of the university to focus their attention on Swami and to inspire our students to be future messengers of Sai mission. Not to my knowledge. This has to be taken up as early as possible. The second, the devotees who are indifferent, who were not just mindful of what is going on. They don't bother about what is going on. We can't help them. Just as they are indifferent, we can't help but to be indifferent to them in turn. And then those who are interested in their studies, children, they are not interested in any Sai mission at all. But we can help the confused people, the confused section of devotees who are in dilemma to do or not to do, what is correct, what is not correct. And then we can also help the new generation that has been visiting Prashanthalayam and Sai centers all over the world, inform them, appraise them what Baba said on different topics. Keeping all this in our view, we would like to share with our viewers certain points of immediate interest. Therefore, my friends, the topic for this talk is need of the hour. What is the need of the hour? Let us question ourselves. Well, I tried to epitomize and put as briefly I can the aims and objectives what Baba said to us. Certain the qualities that we are supposed to have. There are lots of things he said, but for the moment I want to share with you a couple of them. The first and the foremost, God has given us intellect. What for? Intellect is a decision-making instrument given to us. It is judgmental. It is gifted with power of discrimination. We should be knowing what is right, what is wrong. So let's all exercise our intellect, discriminate, know what is right and what is wrong. This Baba said in the month of August on 28th, 1996, I tell you, not today. He spoke of intellect and we are not aware of the intellect within us. We remain as we have been. Therefore, my friend, wake up, come on. Wake up. Let us make our intellect alert and try to discriminate between right and wrong. As Baba puts it, what is ephemeral and what is eternal? Ephemeral, transient, senescent, something like that which is momentary, mundane, worldly, and that which is eternal, everlasting, immortal. That's what Baba wanted us to think of. Therefore, the discrimination has to be exercised in particular today. And then in this process, I want to warn everybody, devotees in general and youngsters in particular, what Baba said, that we should be very careful in respect of our association. We cannot move with everybody. Those who are against our principles, those who are against our norms, against the teachings of Swami, we cannot mingle with them. So we should exercise our choice as to whom, with whom we should move, and we should run away from the bad company. As Baba said it, run away from the bad company. Then you may ask me, what is a good company? What is a bad company? Good company is that which agrees with Sai principles, Sai way of life, and Sai teachings. Bad company is that which will take away from this right path. That will make us weak ultimately. This is what we call satsang. Tell me your company, I shall tell you what you are, Baba said many times. Therefore, my friends, everybody will have to be careful today in choosing the company. There are some people who are with us. They will try to divert our attention. They will try to misinterpret facts. And they may tell you certain things of which you are not aware of. So be careful as you choose your company, particularly in spiritual path. This Baba said long back in the month of February on 28th, 1995, satsang, good company, be very careful what Swami said. In addition to that, Swami also said, when we are good in good company, we have good vibrations. When you are in a bad company, likewise you'll have bad vibrations. Vibrations will have effect on our mind, will have an effect on our ideas, will certainly influence our thoughts. So we have got to be very careful, as Baba said. And third point which I want to bring to your attention, very important point is this. Unfortunately, we find many people who come here for business prospects, who come here for their personal influence, gain, selfishness, self-interest, political motives, with ambition for positions, properties, and politics. It's very unfortunate. This is a spiritual center. This is a center of awakening. This is a center of self-inquiry. To go within, nothing like outwardly profits, like pain, gain, whatsoever. And therefore, my friends, let us focus our attention only on God, no one else. Let him be a member of assembly or parliament, Let me be president of a unit or secretary or whosoever may be. They are not important. Only God and no one else, as Swami said it. I can give you an example that Baba said on April 3rd, 1990. Funnily, he said, human heart is a single sofa. It has no place for another man to sit. Therefore, let us be sure the single sofa with us, the human heart, be a sitting place, a throne for Baba to sit, not for anybody to come and occupy. Only God, no one else. Is that a double sofa? That's what Swami said many times. It's not musical chair. Human heart is not a musical chair to go on shifting, to go on changing. No, single sofa, as Swami said. And at this time, I should also share with you what Baba said. As we know, in navigation, we have a compass. The needle changes in a particular direction, always pointing towards the north. The compass during navigation, every ship will have it. Like the compass needle that shows the direction, the needle of our mind should always be directed towards God. It should be pointed out towards God, not towards anybody else. As Swami himself gave that example, in the month of January, on 14th, 1995, I mean, giving these references to establish the authenticity, the credibility, the accountability of these statements. Any devotee will have to accept, because they are Swami's words. You cannot interpret in your own way. He said it in unambiguous terms, very clear, giving no scope for any benefit of doubt. And then I can also give you another thing Swami said. Let not preach. Let not go on talking. Today, unfortunately, we have got so many people who go on speaking about what? About that they do not do. About that what do not have. About that they don't stand as an example anymore. Therefore, Swami says, forget everything. Be an example for yourself. Let you be an example for yourself, for others to follow, for others to emulate. That's what Baba said in the month of August, on 8th, 2017. Be an example. Be an example means what? In your conduct, in your words, in your humility, and the way how you behave yourself with elders, and then in the love and faith in God. Love and faith in God. These are the qualities. To be an example to the rest of the community, to the rest of the Sai devotees, for them to follow, rather than giving speeches, keeping ourselves busy, like politicians going around people. It won't serve the purpose. We are supposed to be best examples, according to Swami. Swami often tells this also, acting this way. It is like seesaw. Seesaw. If one is upwards, other will be downwards. If one is upwards, other will be downwards. So if you give priority to God, yes, world will be less in weight. If you give priority to world, God will be less in its weight. Understand which side you should weigh, which side you should value. That's what Bhagavan has said on April 28th, 1997. And further, because of certain petty reasons, because of certain very silly politics, people are getting divided. With my humble experience across the world, many centers are divided, many centers. They may not openly admit. People in positions, they don't leave. Youngsters are not ready to occupy. Elders are not ready to quit. Youngsters are not ready to enter. What is to be done? Politics, politics everywhere. That's why we are divided. In this state of affairs, my friends, Be sure that we cannot achieve anything, anything. On the other hand, we'll be pulling Sai movement backwards. So, to be forward, onward, to march ahead into the future, for a couple of decades to come, the most essential thing today is unity, which is very much important, as Baba said, in the month of November 24th, in the year 1998. So far as Swami is concerned, we should forget our differences. Let there not be differences on grounds of caste, creed, nationality, gender, region. Very silly. God is one. Why do you want to be divided like that? So in respect of God, in a spiritual organization, unity is very, very essential. No other consideration, please understand that. Swami is main factor. And further, Baba said, with the spirit of unity, we should take to service activities, because service and Sai go together. Service is the easiest path to win His blessings, to win His grace. Therefore, forgetting all our differences, let us stand united. Let us sacrifice. If there's going to be some unity when I just step down my position, yes, I'm the first down to step down my position. If unity is going to be established, if I'm to compromise somebody, I'm ready to compromise with anybody with folded hands for the sake of Swami, for the purpose of unity. Individual is not important. Institution is important. Therefore, in this Sai organization, which is a mighty, universal, spiritual organization, if unity is not here, where else can you expect? Where else can you expect? So let us examine ourselves everywhere, to what extent we are united. Why there is no total unity amongst ourselves? Let us work out all the differences, settle all our differences once for all, and stand united, and Swami will be very proud of us. Further, He said, I'll be extremely happy, please note, I'll be extremely happy if you are united, Baba said. If we are not going to make Baba happy, why this membership, why this position, why this place, what for? It's all waste of time. If we don't walk along the way in the direction He wanted us, all this will be useless, my friends. Let us work to achieve this unity if it is missing. Though not we admit publicly. And then I can also tell you that Swami said it. You should not have ill feelings towards each other. You should have brotherly feelings among yourself. You cannot hate anybody. Because in bhajans we say in Arati, Mata Pita Guru Daivamu Mariyanta Nive. When Baba is our father, are we not His children? How can we fight with each other? When Baba is our mother, can we have differences amongst us? When He is God, well, we should not have any differences whatsoever. We should stand united. That's what Bhagavan said. And further, my friends, somebody may come and tell you some story. You start believing it. Somebody will tell you some experience somewhere. You start developing faith in it. This is not the way. Do not follow what you hear. Do not follow what others say. Follow your own conscience. Follow your own conscience. Go by your own experience, not by the experiences of anybody. That's what Baba said. In the month of September 29th, in the year 1960, that's what Baba said. Go by your own experience. Yes? To have experience, what should I do? Well, however much I may tell, fire burns. One may not listen to me. One may not have faith in me. All right, put your hand, get your hand burnt, then you'll have enough experience. What burning is, what fire is. So, having had experience with Swami, having had divine experiences with Swami all these years, we cannot go on changing on silly grounds. Your conscience is the eternal witness. That's what Bhagavan said. Further, some people may come and say, out of love for you, I am telling you, my friend, this. Out of concern, I am telling you. Out of love, I want to take you along the right path. Silly. Silly, utterly foolish. What Baba said is, you can love everybody, but do not trust everybody. Love everybody, don't trust, because trust betrays you. Trust sometimes misplaced cheats you. Therefore, trust may misguide you. Therefore, don't trust anybody, but you can love anybody, as Baba said. In the month of May 6th, the year 2002. So trust not everybody, but love all and serve all. That's what Bhagavan has said. The next important point is this, my friends, about Baba's teachings. We should have correct idea of Baba's teachings. Some people misinterpret. Some people interpret to their convenience. Some people go on quoting Baba at a wrong place, to their own, to their comfort, to their convenience, applicable to their own logic and rationale and reasoning. It's not that. You cannot go on changing Swami's teachings like that. Swami's teachings are direct. It means we have not understood the depth of his teachings, and we don't consider them valid. If we consider him really valid, we don't misquote him. No, we don't do that. As Baba himself said about his teachings in the month of September 27th, year 2006, what did he say about teachings? The entire essence of Vedas is contained in my teachings. That's what Baba said. Swami teachings convey the essence of Vedas. Please understand. And further he said, in my teachings and conversations, you will also find the essence of all scriptures, shastras. That's what Swami said. Therefore, as we go to Swami's teachings, as we listen to his talks, as we read his literature, let us understand, you are going through Veda, you are going through shastras, the scriptures. With that reverence, with that faith, you should go near, so that you'll be able to implement, you'll be able to practice what all he said, what all is expected of us. That's what Swami said. Follow my teachings. You'll achieve success. That's what Bhagavan has said. And he said, love them, adore them, and follow them. Love Swami's teachings. Follow his teachings. Adore his teachings. That is not done today. Worship Swami, act in your way. Don't listen to his teachings. Don't read his literature. No knowledge of the philosophy of Swami. What is that we can achieve? That's why very often we are prone to be misdirected. We are prone to be weak at times. Let us be established very strong in full faith towards Swami from the background of his divine teachings. That's what Swami said. In this talk, I would like to mention very important thing about Swami. We have organization. Is it an organization? Like any other organization in the world? No. Sai organization has a mission with a vision. An organization with a mission and vision is such a Sai organization. What is Sai mission? What is the mission that is going on in his name? What is going on? What does Baba say? Let me bring to your attention. Which he said in the month of July on 4th, 1968. Well, we are yet to know that and we are yet to realize it. What did he say? My mission is not publicity. My mission is not to establish any sect, any creed or any religion. Let us be very clear about it. I don't need publicity. Today, we want publicity only. He said, I have not come here to establish any creed, sect or religion, but we call ourselves a particular sect, a particular group, a particular subgroup. Narrow down the divine program and the divine mission. Let us always remember that. Why? Baba said, all religions are mine. All forms are mine. All names are mine. That we should always bear in our mind. Such universal philosophy, that universal ideology that Swami speaks about. And then Swami said, I have no intention to gather followers. Do you find that elsewhere? What is happening in the world? Everyone wants to have a number of followers, attract followers, pump up their ego, praise them to the skies, make them your followers. Like blind sheep that follow. We are not expected to like that. Swami is not interested in having followers. Because he believes in individuals who follow his teachings. Individuals who have firm faith in him. Individuals who have him in their heart. That's what is important. Not simply, it's a political party, not a political party to have a number of followers. That's what Bhagavan said. I'm not here to collect followers. I'm not interested. And I have no plans to attract anybody. See that. Have we ever examined these lines, my friends? I have no intention to attract anybody. What is happening everywhere? Attraction. Publicity. Pomp. Show. Special techniques. These things are going. Believing that followers, number of followers will stand for your strength and credibility is not so. Swami's divinity is the credibility, that's all, his divinity. Therefore, he doesn't want any number of followers. No, no. He's not interested to collect people around him. And he has not special doctrine, anything whatsoever. And then, what does he say? I have come here to establish faith at the universal level, meaning unity of religions. All religions are one. That is main philosophy. Because we find people having their own way. This is what Swami likes. This Swami does. Who said that he likes? Swami has no likes and dislikes. You have likes and you attribute to him. He is non-dual. Beyond likes and dislikes, Swami is non-dual. Therefore, let us understand that he belongs to everybody and everybody belongs to him. That we should understand it. And then Swami said, my view is this. To show you the path of love. Path of love. Please note this point. Are we on the path of love? Question yourselves. Let us answer. Let's get the answer. Let us let our conscience be satisfied with our answer. And then, and to teach you duty of love. It is your duty to love everybody. If you are a religious man, if you are a member of the organization, obligation to love. You are obliged to love because he loved us. Swami loved all of us. Therefore, it's necessary for all of us to love everyone all around.